PHP. It's a programming language that's mostly used for web development. Whenever you create a PHP script, that script is passed to the PHP interpreter and compiled to human-readable code. In many cases, that's HTML, but it could also be JSON or XML, whatever you want. And the easiest way to run PHP is to create a script and run it using your terminal. So in essence, a CLI script. But since PHP is most often used for web development, running a CLI script doesn't get us very far. So instead, PHP is usually run by your web server. And when that server receives a request, it will find the PHP file that should be run for that request. It will compile that file on the fly and send a response, HTML, JSON, whatever you want, to the client. Now, popular web servers like Nginx, Apache, or Kadi have modules available that allow them to run PHP, but there are also solutions for local development. So you can use Docker, Memv, Valet, Homestead, just run Apache or Nginx locally. But PHP also has a built-in web server, one that doesn't require to install anything but PHP and can be run straight from the terminal. So if you want to get started with PHP and just play around a little, the built-in server is probably the easiest option. So the most important benefit of having a server-side programming language is that your server and this, your PHP code, it can keep track of data across requests. While HTTP is a stateless protocol, it doesn't remember anything between requests, PHP can in fact keep track of state. Stuff like cookies and sessions, databases, logged in users, PHP knows about all those things. And thus you can create very rich web experiences, from blogs to forums, from knowledge bases to social media. PHP is pretty much everywhere. It's still the largest programming language for the web, and that won't change anytime soon. So what does it look like? Well, the most basic PHP code can actually be mixed with HTML. And although that's still done in some places, most projects take another approach. There are a bunch of frameworks that take control of HTML rendering and provide custom template engines. You can think of them as markup languages on their own that are compiled to PHP, which is in turn compiled to HTML. The language itself has seen quite the metamorphosis over more than 25 years. What started as a simple scripting language to render dynamic HTML has grown in a stable and robust programming language. And of course, there are the basics like classes and interfaces for proper object-oriented programming. But PHP has quite a lot more features these days. And just to name a few, there are generators, traits, enums, fibers, also known as coroutines, a just-in-time compiler, the match operator, attributes, and a robust type system. And just to illustrate what I mean with metamorphosis, here's a simple PHP class representing a data transfer object 10 years ago. And here's that same class with the same functionality written today. Next, there's a huge community. Whatever problem you're encountering, chances are someone already has a solution for it. So that means that you can focus on solving the business problems of your clients instead of having to come up with your own technical solutions. I'm talking about stuff like database communication, asynchronous programming, logging, and CLI integrations. PHP has a huge amount of low-level components all ready to use. And on top of that, there are a bunch of very popular frameworks. Laravel with more than 4 million installs per month, or Symfony with almost 1 million per month. These are mature frameworks in the making for over a decade. They offer solutions for most of the things you'll ever need as web developers. Database abstractions, authentication, routing, queue managers, sending mails, encryption, templating, form validation, and I can continue a bit longer, but I think you get the point. PHP has an incredibly rich ecosystem that helps build quality software. You might be worrying about performance at this point because we're compiling quite a lot of code on the fly for every request. Imagine a website serving thousands or even millions of requests. How would PHP be able to handle that? That's actually one of PHP's remarkable properties. It's incredibly fast to compile code on the fly. And that is thanks to the massive work that's put into performance. The benefit is what I like to call a very fast development feedback loop. Whenever you make a change to your code, that change is instantly there the next time you refresh your web page. You don't need to recompile your source code or restart your local development server. It's actually quite a different feeling compared to languages like Java or C# that need that explicit compilation step. And thanks to very efficient caching mechanisms and other smart optimizations, PHP is still very performant. Now, I did mention PHP's type system. Saying that it has evolved substantially in recent years might be a little bit of an understatement, because where PHP used to be a very weak and dynamically typed language, which you can still use, by the way, you now also have the option to write more strict and strongly typed code. There even are a couple of popular tools to statically analyze your code before running it. And while PHP is still a dynamic language, static analysis tools like PHPStan, Psalm, and PHPStorm have opened the door for a whole other kind of programming. Now, explaining the ins and outs of static analysis is outside the scope of this video, but you can check out my Road to PHP series if you want to know more. There's a link in the description. But just to summarize static analysis real quickly, it's a game changer, especially for large projects and when working with teams of developers in the same code base. It allows for stuff like generics and closure types, and it can detect quite a bunch of possible bugs without ever running your code. It's a whole other kind of programming that we never thought we'd do in PHP 10 or 20 years ago. So that's the PHP promise these days: a robust, mature, and performant programming language, a modern day syntax, a sparkling community that helps you solve most of the problems you can think of, and just a fun language overall. It is worth learning PHP because it's not going away anytime soon, and it's quite fun. So have you worked with PHP before? Do you like it? Share your thoughts in the comments below so that the people who haven't heard of it or never used it before can see the awesomeness of our favorite programming language. Leave a like, subscribe, you know what to do. Until next time.